everyone. I am a centenarian clock born in Guangzhou during the Qing Dynasty. I got the name called Guangzhou clock. I have a golden rose body that is adorned with a sapphire blue enamel dress, embroidered with auspicious double deer patterns on the collar. The hands of the clock are my heartbeat, tick-tocking for over 100 years. Without me, people back then wouldn't know the exact time.
广钟犀利喎，又靓又准时。
以后去睇大戏唔怕迟到啦。
My entire body is adorned with Western patterns showcasing the craftsmanship of Guangzhou artisans, including the initial letters spelling Canton representing my place of origin. Even my shoes are designed in the European architectural style. Everyone in the palace left me, but now, as I have surpassed 100 years, my body is not as strong as before.To better present me in the museum to meet all of you, the doctors are diligently treating and taking care of me. If you don't believe me, let Valeria take you to see.
Hello, 大家好，我是来自俄罗斯的小乐。今天要去看一间广州首富的现场。张老师你好。
哎，你好，小鹿。
老师，请问广钟有多少年的历史？
广钟主要是当时明末清初，传家是为了能够在中国传教，然后把这个钟表呢，当时进献给皇帝。那么后期呢，咱们广钟呢也开始独立制作钟表，皇帝呢对广钟这个钟表当时也比较喜欢，那么所以呢会。就是督促广州会大力的去生产制作一些广州钟表。那么到了乾隆后期，那么咱们的广州钟表就已经做得非常的完美了。
像咱们这个小型的这个座钟呢，它主要是外观是以蓝底珐琅为主，就是你看这蓝色的基底的这种珐琅，一般就叫广珐琅，它就是能够基本上断定它是广钟。直到打上广东字样的这个机芯，就可以说明是广钟的最巅峰时期的一个制作产品了。
这种钟表出现了什么问题？需要做什么修复？
因为这个钟表是百年前的一个产品嘛，随着这个时间的增长，这些钟表呢可能有锈蚀啊，或者是有磨损啊，或者有损伤，通过我们的修复，最后将这个钟表呢恢复如初，让它达到最初的一种表演功能。
工博院与广东省博物馆呢建立了一个古钟表联合修复室，通过我们故宫的这个团队的这个修复，然后同时加上广东省博物馆咱们这种科技保护团队的一个对钟表的一个检测分析，还有咱们后来的对钟表的 3D 扫描，我们对钟表进行一个全方位的修复的一个过程。
我们什么时候能够在广东省博物馆展厅看到它完整的样子？
明年的时候呢，广东省博物馆会办一个钟表的一个专题展，到时候呢也欢迎你呢能够来到广东省博物馆，更加直观的来感受广东的一种神秘色彩。
As the century-old chimes resound once again, the distant past feels within arm's reach. During that era of bustling trade, Guangzhou artisans pursued excellence. Guangzhou-made products gained worldwide acclaim, such as Guangzhou clocks, Guangcai porcelain, Cantonese embroidery, and Cantonese enamel. Here I have discovered the vibrant answers of Yunnan culture.